Here after Colorado's fifth preseason practice, their first in full pads, Mel Tucker said it's their best preseason practice so far.
Yeah, I think you guys love putting on the pads, and they got to hit a little bit in shells, but I mean, I think it's just different with pads, and certainly it sounds like guys got after it today.
Tucker said that their offensive identity in terms of being able to run the football is really coming together. The O-line had a good day today, and he continues to praise pretty much all the backs on this roster.
Yeah, I mean, he mentioned just about everybody. He didn't mention Joe Davis, but who knows, maybe that's an oversight. But he mentioned everybody. He said Jarek Broussard really showed up, and that's the first time we've heard his name this camp. And we've heard pretty consistently Jaron Mangum and Alex Fontenot and Deion Smith. But Jarek Broussard, he mentioned today as stepping up. He said those guys are falling forward, and the offensive line is really taking on that identity. And he also kind of called out the defensive line a little bit and said those guys now know, hey, you better bring it tomorrow. You better come with an answer. And so, I think that that's a great thing for this team. We've been hearing back since the Embry days that this is what a lot of these coaches have wanted as an identity for mm-hmm. this team, running the football. If these guys can do that, that's going to be huge this season.
And I think if you create that identity, you don't need to rely on Laviska Shenault out of the Wildcat quite right. as much. I actually think there would be a lot less wear and tear on his body if he returns punts and doesn't do a lot of the Wildcat stuff. And maybe in critical situations, because Laviska's so good at that, you could do that. But certainly not to the extent they did last year.
Yeah, I almost think you kind of want to put him back there a couple times just because they did it last year. And even if you don't run him quite like he did, maybe do something different out of it. But yeah, I agree with you. You've got to have that identity of running the football. You'd rather have Jaron Mangum, a guy like that, get those 2 yards on, fourth and one or whatever, than have Laviska Shenault do it.
You had a chance to talk to Jalen Sammy, one of the biggest Buffaloes, without question. Stepped up in the spring. How are things coming along for him this preseason?
Yeah, he's said things are going very well. He actually mentioned, he said, being the biggest guy there, he goes, well, I was the biggest guy until Austin Williams showed up. But So he mentioned that it's nice having some other big guys there. But sounds like things are going really well for him, and he feels like he's picking up this defense, learning a lot from playing next to Mustafa Johnson, loves playing next to Terrence Lang. And, people forget, Tyson Summers mentioned this the other day. He said, we kind of think of Jalen as an older player, but he hasn't played a college snap yet.
Yeah.
But he hasn't played a snap of football in 3 years. So he's pretty excited. He was counting down the days. He mentioned, I think it's only 24 days, and I can't wait.
He's very athletic for his size. The one concern I have there is being able to play with leverage, because he is a really tall guy, being able to play with good pad level. And if you get tired out there, conditioning is going to be huge for him, because I think back to Javier Edwards' first year here.
Yeah.
When he got tired and wasn't playing with good pad level, it was bad. He was getting blocked downfield. It doesn't matter how big you are. If you don't, as they say, the low man wins in
right.
football. I had a chance to talk to John Van Deest, who – you can just tell, and Mel Tucker confirmed this as well, that he is putting every ounce of effort he can. Mm-hmm. He lost 9 pounds during Saturday's practice, needed 3 IV bags afterward. He is just, he works harder than, as hard as anybody on this football team.
Yeah, and you love the things that Mel Tucker said about him, that he puts in that effort. Tucker said that after practice today, he came up to him and said, Coach, what can I do to get better? And just every day he's doing that. And I don't know if he's going to win that job or not. I would kind of put the odds towards him. But when you have a guy like that, that means a lot. I mean, you can tell that he's into it, and it means a lot to him. I think that's huge. And I think if you've got him next to Nate Lammy, you got two guys that are going to be smart and know what to do.
And this is the longest stretch he's been healthy for in a long time, dating back to early in his high school career. So he says he's not knocking on wood, but he's praying to God every day that he stays healthy, and the Buffs need him to. You had a chance to talk to Mikael Onu as well. Sounds like he's, now that things are getting more physical, he's really starting to flash.
Yeah, he's an interesting one. I talked to him over the summer when the first was announced he was going to come here, and he mentioned to me, he goes, well, the defense from SMU to here is pretty similar. It's just a lot more terminology. I asked him, now that you're here, would you still say that? And he goes, no, it's quite a bit different. He goes, it's a lot more challenging. So he's kind of he said he's swimming a little bit right now, but physically he's there. And I mentioned to him, I said, we didn't see it with the ones on Saturday. He goes, I don't really care. He goes, I don't really want to be with the ones right now, because I don't deserve to be, because I don't really know this defense. He goes, I would rather just kind of learn, because I don't really care where I'm at right now, but I want to learn this defense. He feels it's going to take another few days to really learn. He feels like he's further along than he thought he would be, but it's going to take a few more days. But yeah, physically, the things we're hearing is once they put on the pads, which they did today, that he's really going to start showing up.
Yeah, and he's not quite as tall as I was expecting.
Right.
But given his experience, his intelligence, his willingness to play physical, and also versatility is a big thing for him. He played nickelback in both safety roles at SMU. So he's going to be kind of a Swiss Army knife for them there. I think he's going to be on the field a lot, even if he might not be starting out with the ones to begin camp.
Yeah, for sure. And I think, you know, when you've got a safety group that, you know, I think there's talent back there with like Mark Perry and Aaron Maddox, and, you know, Darian Rakestraw has, you know, really, you know, learned this offense well. You've got guys back there. Trey Udofia has got experience at corner, now moving over to safety. You've got guys back there that can play, but when you've got a guy like Mikael Onu who has played a lot of games in Division I football, that means a lot.
All right, 5 preseason practices in. We'll be back with more analysis on Wednesday.